hello, konnichiwa, and hola. What is up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Anyway, to the video!
Sup, today I'm gonna be playing, and you're gonna be watching some... Well, for one, you're going to be seeing a lot of time lapses. That's going to be a whole big thing. Because, quite frankly, I'm going to be trying out a bunch of combos today. Because I'm going to be trying to figure out all of the best stuff to use in the arena for early game, early middle game, and late middle game, and true late game. Anyhow, I'll see you whenever we cut to that part. Okay, cool. So first of all, let me go ahead and tell you what my criteria are for early game. Tier 1 through 3, that's it. So from stomp to punch is what I'm allowed to use. And of course, I will, like, I'll probably only use 2 and 3, but I don't know. Anyhow. Cut to the time lapse. Okay, guys, so I've been doing some research, and it turns out you actually can use a rank 1 and a rank 3. Now, like I said, I was limiting myself from rank 1s to rank 3s, so that's actually kind of funny. But look at that. Like, you just kind of got to run a little bit, like, run circles around them. Then use these, and chances are, if you can pull it off, you won't even take any damage. Of course, you do have to be kind of specific with the controls, but as for the moves, they hit everyone at once. And so, yeah, honestly, if you're just grinding for levels, for quick levels, with only, like, as a noob, this is what I'd recommend. So, the noob sector is explosive plus magic. Anyhow, on to the noob the early middle stages of the game. The requirements for this stage I have decided would be obviously from rank 1, but now we can go all the way down to, I'm going to say, rank 4. Oh, perfect. So now we can have rank 1 through, or no, because rank 1 through 5, let's say. Yeah, that seems reasonable. Rank 1 through 5. So that's right, you might be seeing Supernova, maybe Stealth, maybe even a Lava Tsunami. I don't know. I gotta do some research. See you back whenever I'm done with my research. Okay, cool. So after doing some research and fighting through, like, multiple waves, as you, well, you might have caught, you probably didn't. I died a few times with some other combos, but this combo finishes the wave. It has plenty of AoE, so you don't necessarily have to get, like, up close with them and get damaged. And, oh god, chickens. This is one of the harder ones, actually. Because of just how many chickens it spawns. Yeah, so chickens and aliens plus skeletons are the two hardest ones from what I've done, from what I've experienced, just because of how many chickens it spawns. Do you see that? Like, bro, look at how quickly that cleaned up that entire wave. And look at how much XP that gave me. That gave me, like, half of level 24. I think this one is pretty self-explanatory. It clears out the wave easily. It does a lot of damage, and it's pretty good AoE, so you don't even necessarily have to get hit. Just watch out. Spawning noobs. Like, I'm just going to give you another demonstration. So they're all on your back. Use fog. Because, yeah, that ticks multiple times. This only ticks once, but it makes up for it with just how much damage it does. Yeah, that's right. It instantly annihilates a wave. So that is my my combo for late middle game. See you whenever, or as for the late game, or no, that's early middle game. As for the late middle game, everything from world one, so everything up to tier 8 is usable. So you're probably going to see a lot of UFO, maybe some clone in here, get some clone death action. And then, like, I'll see you, well, I'll talk to you again whenever I have that combo decided. Okay, cool. So apparently, in the middle of recording this frickin' video, a new update got released, 4.5. It added 1v1s, it added a new PvP system. I'm in the Magic League now. So it added a new ability, which of course I already have. I had like 3 hints saved up. Speaking of that, the next thing I get is actually a hint, so I'll be back up to 3. But I have robot now. Yeah, I know, it's weird, but whatever. I have it. So, you kind of already know what I'm going to have to say, because I can't do any research for this. And what I'm going to say might shock a lot of people, but Super Heal and Demon are actually pretty good whenever comboed together. Not as good as Tentacles Medic, which I'm also going to say for the end, for the late game, aka the end game. But, like, that's just crazy to me. Anyhow, you should hopefully know what the next video is going to be. If this video is what it is, he said that he would also do a one about a PvP. I'm just trying to get out of this gigantic frickin' palace right now. Jesus. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, this is a whole battleground. And oh boy, is it convoluted. Never mind. Oh, wow, yeah. So now the PVPs are held, like, right there. Wow. Okay. That's how people kept on. Oh, yeah, that cuts off the secret area, which means the secret area badge is like very hard to get. Wow. But yeah. So, my research got cut off mid-video because mid-video there was an update. Adding 1v1s, a better PvP system, the ability to get stuck on the PvP islands. Yeah, they do need to fix that. That's like my one thing. They definitely need to fix that. Just to show that it is, in fact, the next day. Can almost claim my daily rewards for day two, which is a hint. But anyhow, y'all, I'll see you next time. Bye.